The planet's climate is changing. This is undeniable. Climate change presents a critical challenge for global food security. The men and women who produce our food are hit the hardest due to consequences of climate change. Climate change impacts on agriculture are being witnessed all over the world, but countries like India are more vulnerable in view of the huge population dependent on agriculture, excessive pressure on natural resources, and poor coping mechanisms. NECRA project has been undertaken by RAKVK in the coastal village of Bongheri. The geographical status of the village due to its proximity to the brackish water river Matla has often been at the center of natural calamities like cyclones, inundation with brackish water during high tides, breaching of embankment, prolonged water stagnation, etc.
চাষবাসের খুব সমস্যা ছিল, কারণ নিচু জায়গা, বর্ষার দিকে অত্যাধিক জল জমে যেত, আবার নদীর বাঁধ ভেঙেও জল ঢুকে যেত, কোনো কোনো সময় চাষও হতো না, আবার হওয়া চাষের মধ্যেও নদীর জল ঢুকে গিয়েও চাষের ক্ষতিপূরণ হতো।
To address the issue in holistic and proactive mode, the Indian Council of Agriculture Research, ICAR, has initiated a mega network project, National Innovation in Climate Resilient Agriculture, NECRA. The project aims to enhance resilience of Indian agriculture to climate change through strategic research and technology demonstration.
2011 সালে আমাদের এই নিগ্রা প্রকল্পটি এই বনগেরি গ্রামে রূপায়িত হয়।
The NECRA project is aimed at foreseeing future climatic changes in the coastal belts of South 24 Parganas district. Its effect on agriculture-based livelihood and preparedness of the community to shift to secondary livelihood options. In this direction, several alternative modules have been visualized and taken into consideration by RAKVK for wide-scale testing and demonstration during implementation of the project. One of the major interventions taken up by the RAKVK was plantation of mangrove vegetation by the villager along the river embankment, which could absorb the burn of the cyclonic storms and high tides, thereby sparing the village from mass destruction and to conserve local biodiversity.
এই গ্রামেতে নদীর পাড়গুলো ছিল খুব নিচু, তখন এই সময় এই নদীতে গাছ ম্যানগ্রোভ গাছ খুব কম পরিমাণে ছিল। এই মাদলা নদীর ভেসে আসা ম্যানগ্রোভ গাছের ফল আমরা এগুলোকে একটা নার্সারি ভাবে বীজ রোপণ করি। সেই নার্সারির মাধ্যম থেকে প্রায় 80 ফুট চওড়া এবং প্রায় 4000 ফুট লম্বা নদীর চরে এই ম্যানগ্রোভ চারাগুলো নিয়ে আমরা রোপণ করি, ঝড়ের হাত থেকে রক্ষা পাবো বলে সেইভাবে আমরা ভেবেছি।
Land shaping and rainwater harvesting, an effective agrotechnology which helps to harvest rainwater and utilization of that water for cultivation of vegetables crops in the same field after Kharif paddy has been promoted in the region. Both the widened pond embankment and the land embankment are used for vegetable cultivation throughout the year. At the same time, pisciculture with duck rearing is taken up in the pond.
বাজারে বিক্রয় করছি, করে ওর মধ্যে থেকে আমরা বছরে বা ছ মাসের মধ্যে থেকে 50-60 হাজার টাকা করে উন্নত করছি।
In land shaping, one fifth of the land surface was excavated to make a pond, and at the same time, the height of the remaining land was increased by 1 to 1.5 feet with the help of the dug out soil. Both the land and pond embankments were also raised by 3 feet and broadened at the top up to 3 to 4 feet. The modified land survived prolonged water stagnation during rainy season. It became fit for cultivation of short duration and high yielding paddy varieties Satabdi that gave 56% more return than traditional variety Savita. The improved variety matured 35 days prior to the traditional variety. Thus, the farmers got an extra month to prepare their land for the next winter crop. The modified embankments provided extra scope for growing vegetables throughout the year. The pond stored rainwater at any surface runoff, thus ensuring protective irrigation during dry spells in the rainy seasons. The remaining fresh water of the pond helped the farmers to take a second or even third crop, which was beyond imagination earlier. The pond is used for fishery for 8 to 10 months. The cropping intensity has grown from 100% to 220% within 2 years. Land shaping increased the net return of a farmer by six-fold. It also created additional job opportunity for the landless laborers within the village during the lean months. During Kharif season, water remains stagnant in the lowland situation, thus inhibiting vegetable cultivation. Cultivation of long duration paddy again delays the release of lands to be ready for timely vegetable cultivation in Ravi seasons. To overcome the situation, a peripheral canal is dug out and the earth is added to the existing land embankment to raise it up to a 3 feet height and broaden to 5 feet width. On an average, 5 to 10% of the total land thus could be brought under additional cultivation. Vegetables like okra, cowpea, and bitter gourd are then cultivated over this strengthened pond during Kharif season with almost no chance of submergence. The problem of salinity is also avoided in oil cultivation during Ravi summer season. Farmers with small land holdings could optimally utilize their small piece of land by adopting this system. In Kharif season, the furrow is used for fish cultivation while the ridge is used for vegetable cultivation.
11 সালে এই নিগ্রা প্রকল্প আমার এই নালা বাঁধ তৈরি করে দিয়েছে কৃষি বিজ্ঞান নিগ্রা প্রকল্প থেকে তাতে আমার এই চাষবাস করি এখন টুকিটাকি আর বাইরে আমার কাজ করতে যেতে হয় না এতেই
Rejuvenation of Kripakhali Canal, a stretch of 4 kilometer canal renovated for rainwater harvesting.
আমাদের ক্যানেলটা কয়লা মজে যায় মজে যাওয়ার পরে আমরা চাষবাস করতে পারতাম না কাজ করতে যেতাম নদীতে মাছ ধরতে যেতাম বাইরে ইট ভাটা কাজ করতে যেতাম মাটিতে মাটি কাটতে যেতাম নিগড়া প্রকল্প থেকে কাটার পর আমরা এখান বিশাল উপকৃত পাচ্ছি
A total 500 farm families benefited from this rejuvenation of canal. Out of all generation of 6,000% days of farm labor, over 4 months has checked exodus of villager by checking migration of 15,000% days of labor. Presence of soil salinity during Ravi and water logging condition during Kharif are the major deterrents for pursuing profitable field crop cultivation. Selection of the right crop varieties was the key to sustain productivity and profitability. Improved varieties of salt tolerant crops like sunflower and sweet potato was also promoted in the Nikra village. To reduce indiscriminate and injudicious application of chemical pesticides, it was decided to start production of biocontrol agents at farmers' own house. Local farmers were trained in production of trichoderma viridi with a low-cost technology. They were supplied with the necessary inputs like pressure cooker, culture transfer chamber, mother culture, etc. To minimize the use of chemical fertilizers, soil test-based fertilizer recommendation approach was taken up by RAKVK. As an effort to rejuvenate soil health, improvised vermicomposting chambers have been demonstrated in the Nikra village. Animal health and vaccination camps were organized to provide the animals with deworming drugs, vitamins and minerals, and immunization of animals against HS, BQ and FMD were also carried out by RAKVK. Most of the farm families of Nikra village were used to raising of indigenous poultry birds. The production both in terms of meat and eggs was very low. There were also incidents of disease and mortality in these birds due to climatic variations at different times of the year. Trace-tolerant dual-purpose poultry bird RIR has been promoted among marginal and landless farmers. Ornamental bird rearing involves growing of lovebirds, cocktail, java, finch, etc. in cages in homestead condition. It provides a lucrative source of income for the landless community of Sundarbans.
ট্রেনিং গেছিলাম পাখির জন্য ক্লাব থেকে আমার 15টা পাখি দিয়েছে দিলে সেই পাখি নিয়ে আমি চালাভাঙা করি করতে করতে যখন সংসারে অভাব পড়ে এই 50-60টা পাখি হয়েছিল যখন সংসারে অভাব পড়ে 2-4টা বিক্রি করে সংসারে অভাব মিটাই
The Nikra village of Bongheri is susceptible to frequent storms and cyclones, rendering it vulnerable to ingress of brackish water from the adjacent river. This may lead to mass mortality of the existing freshwater indigenous fish species. However, the fish tilapia, with a wide range of salinity tolerance, has been found to be unaffected due to this sudden change in their environment.
এই মনোসেক্স ক্লাবে আমি 70-80 খরচা হয়েছে, আমি মাস 30-40 মতো বেঁচেছি। বেঁচে আমি এখনও যা মাছ আছে এখনও প্রায় 80-90 টাকা বেচা কেনা হবে।
A seed bank on paddy was started in the year 2013 with the participation of farmers with a total of 170 kg paddy seed. The success of this participatory approach was given a boost by supplying 4 number of seeds beans to the VCRMC.
আমাদের গ্রামের থেকে হারিয়ে যাওয়া বিগত দিনের যে সমস্ত বীজ সেগুলোকে আমরা সংগ্রহ করে আমরা সিড বিনেতে রাখি এবং প্রয়োজনে চাষীদেরকে আমরা সেই বীজগুলোকে আমরা
To reduce the impact of the climate changes on agriculture, intimation of local weather data and its pattern can be managed through the agro-meteorological data analysis. RAKVK NIMPIT has arranged weather forecasting and agro-advisory service in Bonkheri village under NICRA project. The NICRA project united the villagers to fight against the climate change mediated impacts on agriculture. The 50 crore liters of additional rainwater harvested throughout the project intervention helped to take additional crops in 1/4 of the village area after kharif paddy. The average annual family income rose from ₹24,500 in 2011 to ₹68,550 in 2017.
In this endeavor, the scientists, technocrats, bureaucrats, policy makers, the national leaders of different countries, farmers, etc. are thinking how we can get rid of from the ill effect of the climatic aberrations. Our Krishi Vigyan Kendra NIMPIT has developed, demonstrated and well documented and also upscaled few climate resilient potent technologies with the help and support from the ICAR CREDA Hyderabad, ICAR Kolkata Center to make the agriculture more sustainable, profitable, equitable and stable even in the event of climatic aberrations.
Farming community of South 24 Parganas needs to build their resilience and ability to adopt the changing climate in a way that they can feed a growing population without further depleting precious preserves of soil and water. Climate resilient agriculture is an approach to identify the production system, taking best response to the impacts of climate change and to adjust the system to suit local environment conditions now and in future. Climate change has become a challenge to our food system, but it's also an opportunity for us to innovate and adopt. RAKVK and farmers of this region are working together to become resilient to climate change on agriculture. Together, we can make climate resilient agriculture possibility with new eco-friendly approach. Climate smart agriculture aims to help find new ways to adopt and thrive under climate change.